Welcome back students. In our previous class, we have studied about Euclid's division lemma and the process to find the HCF of the given positive numbers. Now proceeding to next, the next topic of the real number chapter is Fundamental Theorem of Arithmetic. Children, according to this theorem, it says that every composite number can be expressed as the product of primes, and their prime factors are unique. The order of prime factors may change. Let us make it clear by taking an example. Suppose 6 is a composite number, and when you prime factorize the 6, you will get two prime factors, 2 and 3. So either you write the prime factors in the order of 2 into 3 or 3 into 2, both are the same. When you again factorize 36, you will have the prime factors 2 and 3 only. In this case, you will have 2 2s and 2 3s. But there you can observe that in 6 and 36, the prime factors are unique, 2 and 3. There is no change in their prime factors. So this is the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. It is also known as unique factorization theorem. This is also known as unique factorization theorem. Now coming to next, rational number. A number which terminating or repeating are called rational number. Or you may also called it a number in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers, but Q is not equal to 0, is called rational number. Thereafter, irrational number. Irrational number, the numbers which are non-terminating and non-repeating are called irrational numbers. Now students, come to the some problems related to this chapter. Our first question is, show that root 2 is irrational number. We have to show that root 2 is a irrational number. So this can be proved by the contradiction method. The method is, if possible, let root 2 be a rational number. And when it is in rational number, so it can be written in the form of A by B. Here A by B, where A and B are positive integers, but B is not equal to 0. And this A by B is the simplest form of a rational number, where A and B have no common factor other than 1. So root 2 can be written like A by B. Now we are squaring both sides. Root 2 ka square by A by B ka whole square. So when you square of root 2, it becomes 2 equals to A square by B square. By cross multiplying, you have A square equals to 2B square, which meaning that A square is a multiple of 2. Hence A square is divisible by 2 also. And when A square is divisible by 2, then the by property of theorem that A is also divisible by 2. When A is divisible by 2, then suppose A equals to 2m. Now put the value of A in equation first. So 2m square equals to 2b square, which is 4m square equals to 2b square. 2 and 4 will get cancelled 2 times. So we have b square equals to 2m square. Now b square is also divisible by 2 because b square is a multiple of 2, that is 2m square. So b square is divisible by 2. Hence b is also divisible by 2. Then we observed that a was also divisible by 2 and b is also divisible by 2. It means that a and b both have a common factor 2. But this contradicts the fact that a and b have no common factors other than 1. Initially we have assumed that a by b is the form of rational number in the simplest form. So a and b must have common factor only 1, no other than 1. But we got here that a and b are having common factor more than 1. Hence our assumption was wrong, and it proves that root 2 is a irrational number. Now coming to next question. The next question is, without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational numbers will have a terminating decimal expansion or not. Terminating decimal expansion means the division will terminate at some place. Terminate means division remainder will must come zero. So there is a rational number 14,588 by 625. So in this method you have to do simply prime factorization of the denominators. Here denominator is 625. So prime factorize it. When you prime factorize 625, the prime factorization of 625 will be in the form of 2 raised to the power 0 into 5 raised to the power 4. So this is terminating. For terminating decimal expansion, the prime factors of denominators must be in the form of 2m into 5n, where m and n are the whole numbers. The rational number whose prime factorization of denominator is in the form of 2 raised to the power m into 5 raised to the power n, then only it will be terminating. Keep in your mind. Now take another example. 31 by 343. Again you do prime factorization of the denominator 343. By doing prime factorization of the denominator 343, we got 7 raised to the power 3, which is not in the form of 2 raised to the power m into 5 raised to the power n, where m and n are whole numbers. So it is non-terminating. Now the third question is, express each of the following as a rational number in the simplest form. The first our question is 0.16, and there is a linear bracket or bar on the 16, and second is 0.137, and the linear bracket is on 7 only. So first we solve the question 0.16 and bar on 16. This bar means these group of digits are repeating themselves. So we can write 0.16, 16, 16 and so on. Assume it as equation 1. Now you can observe that after decimal place the two digits, that is 1 and 6, are repeating themselves. So you have to multiply, you have to bring the decimal place after two repeating digits, that is by multiplying 100 in equation first. We have 100x equals to 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, 16.16, first from equation 2, you will have 16, 99x equals to 16. So, x equals to 16 by 99. This is the simple fraction or simple form of the 0.1616 per bar. Now, thereafter taken another example, x equals to 1.37 bar. You can observe that in this number, only the digit 7 is repeating themselves. After the decimal place, there are two digits, 3 and 7. 3 is non-repeating, but 7 is repeating. So, you can write it in the form 1.3777 and so on. Suppose it equation 1. Now, since one digit is not repeating after the decimal, so first you multiply it by 10. So, it becomes 10x equals to 13.777. Suppose this is equation number 2. And again, the digit 7 is repeating. So, bring the decimal after the repeating digit. So, now you have to multiply in equation 2 by 10 again. So, now it becomes 100x equals to 137.77. Suppose it is equation number 3. Now, you subtract second by third. Second from third. So, you have 90x equals to 124. Thereafter, x equals to 124 by 90. So, simplify it by 62. 124 can be cancelled by 2 by 62 times and 90 by 2 by 45 times. So, 62 by 45 is the simplest form of the given question. Now, students, here are few questions for practice yourself. You have to do these all questions, and if you have problem, then you should ask. The question number 1 is, prove that root 3 is a rational number. And question number 2 is, express the following in simple fraction. The first fraction is 2.23, and there is bar on the digit 23. And the second question is 34.5678, and there is bar on the digit 7 and 8 only. So, you have to solve these type of questions which we have discussed in this class, and thereafter few more questions to you. The third question is, without actual division, without actually performing the long division, state whether the following rational numbers will have terminating decimal expansion or not. Your first rational number is 13 by 3125, and second is 64 by 445, and third one is 35 by 50. Such type of question also I have discussed in this class, this lecture. So, you can do all of these questions very conveniently and very easily. And fourth question is to you is, the question is asking that, can two numbers have 18 as their HCF and 380 as their LCM? Is it possible for any two numbers having their HCF as 18 and their LCM as 380. You have to give reasons. I want to give you a hint here that HCF must be the factor of LCM. It means that when you divide LCM by their HCF, it will be completely divisible, remainder comes 0. So now you have to find the region which I have already explained in the hint. Now the fifth and the last question is, check whether 15 raised to the power n can end with digit 0 for any natural number n. 15 raised to the power n, suppose any number which is 15 raised to the power n form, for n is a natural number, can end with the digit 0. This can be also solved by the division property. You have to keep in your mind that if a number is number having its digit, last digit 0, then that number must be divisible by either 2 or 5. So by the division property, you can solve these type of questions very easily. First, you prime factorize the number 15, 3 into 5. You can write 3 into 5 raised to the power n. And now by the division property, you have to justify this number 15 raised to the power n will end with the digit 0 or not. So here are 5 questions to you for practice, and do it. And if you again have any problem, then you should ask to me. I think and I hope that all of you have understood the lecture very conveniently, very easily, and try to do your few more questions also from wherever you got available, either you have book or anywhere. So we will come to you from the next lecture, the chapter polynomial. Okay, thank you. We will meet very soon.